年一度的奥运盛会就要在7月26日与法国巴黎展开。在万众瞩目的同时，有一群对数字非常敏感的专家早早就在替法国拨算盘。因为奥运比赛虽然是全球欢腾的体育盛事，但对主办国的财政来说可不一定是一门赚钱的好生意。因为回顾历史，为了举办奥运而搞到负债累累的例子可不是没有。
Local political protests had turned violent during the 1968 Games in Mexico City, and terrorists killed 11 Israeli athletes at the 72 Munich Games.
Invade the Olympic Village, taking 9 Israeli athletes hostage and killing 2 others in their room.
Both incidents showed cities that hosting could be politically risky, or even deadly. When construction problems and corruption led Montreal to spend more than 13 times their budget, they began to view it as financially risky too. So in the late 70s, the IOC was barreling towards disaster,until one city offered to save them. Under one condition, Los Angeles did not want to spend a lot of money. To do that, it offered to use venues it already had instead of build new ones. The LA Coliseum, where the USC football team played, the Forum, where the Lakers played, UCLA's gymnasium and tennis center, and the athletes could just stay in the college dorm rooms. Since the IOC didn't have a choice, it said yes, and was soon glad it did.The 84 LA Games were a success in almost every way, but especially financially. It only cost around $1 billion in 2015 dollars, and LA even made a profit. This should have become the model for future Olympic host cities, but instead, it sparked the problem that is plaguing the Olympics today.LA did such a good job hosting the 1984 Olympics that it re-inspired cities to want to host again. For the 1992 Games, 6 cities submitted bids, then 6 again for 96, 8 for 2000, then a whopping 11 for 2004. As more cities competed, the IOC regained leverage over them again. But instead of sticking to the LA model, it began demanding more. Between 1992 and 2020, the IOC added dozens of new sports to the Games.This required more venues and housing for more athletes, which host cities were primarily responsible for paying for. As the competition intensified, cities felt increasing pressure to make their bids more attractive.
根据媒体整理，自1990年代以来，因为举办奥运而在经济上受到重创的主办国还不少，像是1998年的日本长野冬季奥运，2000年的澳洲雪梨奥运，2004年的希腊雅典奥运。2006年的意大利杜林冬季奥运，2010年的加拿大温哥华冬季奥运，2016年的巴西里约奥运，以及2020年日本东京奥运，都是赔钱榜上有名。即使主办奥运是一场相当难赚，甚至多数都是赔钱的生意，但仍有不少国家乐此不疲。像是法国自1924年举办过第二次夏季奥运之后，就没有申奥成功过。在漫长的32年里，他们申奥四次。2024年是法国魁违百年之后第三次举办奥运。回顾法国主办奥运的历史，他们有三次举办夏季奥运跟三次冬季奥运的记录，目前是世界之最。
Paris will make history. Never has a city turned itself into an Olympic venue like this. The Place de la Concorde, with bleachers already built for breaking, skateboarding, 3x3 basketball and BMX, is now part of Parisian tours. Paris 2024, with the slogan Games Wide Open, under the Eiffel Tower, the beach volleyball arena now has 2,000 tons of imported sand.In an exclusive interview, the mayor of Paris telling NBC News she tried to create a greener games at less cost, more integrated into the city itself, inspired by Rio, with its volleyball arena on the world-famous Copacabana beach. We are ready, she says, and in this difficult time for the world, Paris will have a message of humanity and brotherhood.
根据牛津大学的研究发现，历届的奥运主办国有严重超支的情形发生。可为何仍然有城市想要主办奥运？专家指出，提升城市国际知名度是其中一个诱因。 为了办好这场暌违百年再度来到巴黎举办的体育盛会，法国知名奢侈品牌 LVMH 集团砸下重金，斥资 1.5 亿欧元，相当于52亿台币，成为最强的赞助商。从奥运奖牌设计，打造百万级置放奥运奖牌行李箱，跟超奢华的守护火炬行李箱，以及精致的奥运奖牌托盘，还有为法国代表队开幕式设计制服，处处为挥洒汗水的运动竞赛增添亮眼的时尚光彩。而这一次巴黎还开一个先例，就是借奥运将城市行销推向另一个高层次，他们打出 Olympia Culturel 文化奥运全新品牌，邀请世界各国的艺术家在奥运举办期间来到巴黎，一起为全球游客行塑一个最不一样的奥运体验之旅。
Not only will France's iconic monuments like the Eiffel Tower and the Versailles Palace be the backdrop for many of the sporting events, but there are thousands of exhibitions, shows and concerts taking place. Let's begin then with a look at the opening ceremony with this report from Aurore Dupuy.
It's the most secretive opening ceremony of all times. These computer-generated images might give us an idea of what's coming,but details remain highly confidential. For those who are too impatient to wait for the big surprise on the 26th of July, here are a few clues. The stage will be the River Seine itself. For the first time ever, the show will not take place in a stadium. More than 10,000 athletes and around 100 boats will sail 6 kilometers through the heart of Paris. The parade will end at the Trocadero, right next to the Eiffel Tower.For the artistic director, it's a unique opportunity.
It's the show of a lifetime, the biggest show on earth. For me, artistically, the set is the most beautiful city in the world, with the Seine as my stage and this landscape that I have to work on.
In the lead up to the Games, there's been an explosion of arts and creativity here in France. It's all part of the Cultural Olympiad, a sort of cultural extravaganza that explores the connection between artand athletics. Please can you tell us exactly what is the Cultural Olympiad and where did the idea come from?
It's actually an obligation for all cities that host the Olympics to, of course, show the games, but in parallel showcase a cultural program. In the early editions of the Olympic Games from 1896, there were artistic challenges such as sculpture, painting, music, architecture, and poetry, I believe.So there were 5 artistic disciplines with a medal ceremony. They were Olympics disciplines.
So what can we expect from the French Cultural Olympiad?
The question we asked ourselves was, how can we give a French touch to this Olympiad? We know that French people have a certain taste for all things dialectic, for discussion, for debate, even sometimes for controversy. We challenged the artist to create a discussion and a meeting between the worlds of sport and art. All I can say is that they seized the challenge. Today we have more than 2,500 projects, and these 2,500 projects represent more than 100,000 events around France.
在全球笼罩新冠疫情阴霾长达数年后，在世界经济持续疲弱的困窘下，不止法国需要一个被重新认识的机会，全世界也需要一个好理由，让不同文化的人们放下芥蒂，去拥抱彼此。
Pope Francis giving his apostolic blessing there. Dear brothers and sisters,This week, the Olympic Games begin in Paris, and the Paralympics following. It's a great way to help unite people of different cultures. I pray and hope these events can help be a sign of an inclusive world.And that the athletes and their own witness may be messengers of peace and role models for young people. And in following the ancient tradition of the Olympic Games, may the Olympic Games be an Olympic truce for an end to war or a pause in wars in the world. And I greet all Romans and pilgrims from various countries.